Olympic gold against Italy. The winners are, of course, going to semifinals. And in semifinals, they're going to meet up for the medals for the today's competition.
Sam je optika, ta kabel je zelo zelo. Po mojem bolj, da greste v krok.
Pač ne mo... Samo malček.
Nikola Michel in Stefan Mater. Švica 2, Beatrice Zimmermann, Romain Benet in Julien Nikati.
1 minute, okay.
Velika Britanija, Jeffrey Keller in Louis Hatchwell. Slovenija, Katarina Malašek, Rok Šmejc, Saša Lež. Norveška, Guru Čelšek. Kristus Stewart in Trim Lekker, Češka, Aneška Privilova, Kamil Dostal, Andrej Kegar, Francija, Argelita Boke, Mati Lopez in Philippe Lau, in Italija, Lena Torresi, Eduardo Aliotti in Giuliano Giacomelli. In na štartu sta zdaj pripravili prvi dve tekmovalci, teda obe predstavnici iz Litve. Na modri progi Amelie Jerejmon, na rdeči progi Beatrice Zimmermann. We are ready for the first start. The Swiss team against Swiss team, 3-4 against Swiss 2.
And welcome back. We've got the first heat of the team parallel now on course. Amelie Raymond and Beatrice Zimmermann on course. Toby, they're making pretty fine work of this. What do you reckon?
Yeah, the skiing is pretty nice. Amelie's slightly in the lead against Beatrice. It's super interesting because it's the number one and the number two from yesterday. Amelie is in the lead. We are behind, skating hard, both of them.
Yeah, both looking really strong. Amelie's really powering around here, really showing her dominance. Toby, maybe you can just explain why we've got two Swiss skiers coming down together.
Yeah, it's a little bit confusing here in the first heat because the nation leading the Nation Cup, that means Switzerland is allowed to take part in this event with two teams, Team 1 and 2. And now it's Geet, team one against team two. Amelie was in team number one and Beatrice was on the start for team number two. Now we will see Nicolas Michel against Benet. And Nico will be team number one.
There we have it, the two Swiss racers now on course again. A slightly unusual sight seeing a Swissman racing another Swiss, but I have to say, oh, it's a little bit of a fall there. Oh,
yeah, but it seemed to be okay. And yeah, what we have seen now was a little bit surprising because Nicolai in the red horse was for team one, and Thierry crashed. He was in the lead, so it was a really, really strong performance of the young Swiss guy.
Yeah, like we see in the parallel, we tend to see a few more crashes. It's slightly more spectacular. We can see on the screen now. It looks like. Looks like he just got slightly off balance there. You see his leg going a little bit wild in there, just falling inside the turn there.
Just was using the inside ski a little bit too much and was not pushing with the outside ski. And then he is sliding away. That's just normal crash.
Next up, though, we see Stefan Matter, who won yesterday, took the gold. Taking on Julien Nicati, also from Switzerland. I think this will be an interesting race. Two very, very strong racers coming down next.
It will be very interesting. Stefan is in the blue course. I think the blue course is a little bit better for the Swiss guys because they were able to choose and start it now. Good start of both.
Here we have both races on course. I have to say, yesterday, looking at the both courses, the blue one looks slightly faster, dare I say, maybe a slightly more direct line into the ramp. But both races make good work of this. Stefan Matter taking the lead into 360. Julien Nicati chasing hard.
Yeah, there is no chance for Julia. Stefan was really, really good. And we couldn't see any mistake, and was impressive skiing.
Yeah, really great skiing for both races. I have to say, like I said before, Stefan Matter really is skiing phenomenally well this season.
Maybe for a little bit explanation for everybody who's not that familiar with a Telemark parallel team event. The team with the most points in the Nation Cup is allowed to choose the course, and in that case Switzerland was choosing blue, so that means the first and the third guy is skiing in blue and the second one is skiing in red, but they have a little bit of advantage to ski with two racers in the course they have chosen.
That's right, but next up we see two next races in the course. Jasmine Taylor in the red course from Great Britain and Katarina Malensek from the Czech Republic in the blue course. Sorry, from Slovenia even in the blue course.
They're getting ready to start and go.
Both races out of the start, looking really strong. We've seen some great support here for the Slovenians all weekend. They've had some big crowds. We see Jasmine Taylor taking a bit of a lead here, over the jump into the lead.
Yes, really good. There's no chance for the Slovenians here. Jess was doing fine work here. Good loop now.
Jasmine's had a really strong start to see. Katarina's actually one of the youngest girls in the circuit, 19 years old. So unfortunately, I think this is going to be a win for Jasmine here. But unfortunately, they'll certainly have another go to win it back. But that's a win for Jasmine Taylor from Great Britain.
Strong performance of her. She was skiing very well yesterday with the podium and the third place. So.
Excellent. But next up, we have another Slovenian GB pair. We have Louis Hatchwell from Great Britain in the blue course and Rok Schmidt from Slovenia in the red course. Speaking to Louis Hatchwell yesterday, he was very pleased getting into the top 15 in qualification. Both races now off course. Looking fairly level. It'll be interesting to see exactly who gets into the
position.
Oh, a little bit of a wobble there from Louis Hatchwell. It looks like Roxmet from Slovenia is certainly getting into the lead. Much to the delight of the home crowd here today.
Everything was correct, or if there was a little cheery decision of that, but
there we have it. So Rock over the line first, beating Louis Hatchwell to the mark, and what was a very, very exciting race. We see Louis here looking slightly unstable on the skis. This is, you've got to remember, this is Louis Hatchwell from the Primrose Hill Ski Club in North London.
It's hard to see for us in the slow motion, so we guess everything was correct, and it's 1 point for Slovenia. So it's very interesting because the last heat will decide who is in the next round.
Yes, it's also important to remember that they take the best two times of the races. So GB have the disadvantage of just having two racers on the course today, whereas we'll see Sasha Elish from Slovenia coming down any minute now, seeing what time he can produce. And there we have it, Sasha Elish from Slovenia, now on course. Oh, looking slightly wild there. He's going to have to hike that blue gate. Maybe taking a little bit too much speed off the jump there.
Hard for a racer to be super concentrated when you are skiing alone, because then, yeah, you just have to ski down, and that's sometimes even more difficult to stay concentrated then. So I think that was the mistake he did.
Yeah, Toby, I think you're right. Skiing against the clock is very different to skiing with someone next to you. But there we have it, Sasha Elish from Slovenia coming over the line. I don't think that will be the fastest time necessarily of the Slovenians, but we'll have to find out. Certainly a solid run, other than that little mistake where he had to hike back up. Next up, though, we have the Norwegian-Czech pair, Czech matching. So first up, we have Guro Helgesen from Norway and Anisha Prigova from Czech Republic.
So started now, had a good start, both of them. Guro slightly right before the jump. Guro is skiing very good now, and she is in the lead into the 360.
Yeah, I have to say that it's not a big lead, so I can easily see Anisha taking out a slightly stronger finish here. I saw her skiing yesterday, skiing very well. At the moment, though, it looks like Guro's building on that lead here now. She's a very, very strong skater indeed.
So we have 1 point for Norway and 0 for Czech Republic. Let's see what the man can do.
Yeah, that was a good start for the Norwegian-Czech pairing there. Next up, though, we'll see in the gate, we'll see Adne Kristensen from Norway and Kamil Dostel from the Czech Republic. Here we have it, Kamil on the left-hand side in the blue gates and Adne from Norway in the red gates.
Adne looks very concentrated. And go for it.
And here we have it. Both skiers now on course. The Norwegian-Czech rivalry really is strong at the moment. Oh, a bit of a fall out! Almost skiing straight into him. Toby, what happened there?
There was some problems before the jump and was a little bit back. And Kamil was sliding into the line of Adne. And I'm pretty sure that the jury will decide that there will be a point for Norway because he had no chance, and Kamil was sliding into his line, and that's not allowed.
Yeah, it's very difficult. It's sometimes touch and go to make what happened. We just got Jasmine Taylor from Great Britain in the finish here. Jasmine, tell us a bit about the course. You've obviously skied it once now. How did you find it?
It's really fast. Before the jump's a little strange. You have to kind of do some sort of half turn before the jump and hold telemark. But it's important to keep your speed at that point and maybe absorb and try and really carve the gates after the jump.
Till we have the jury decision, I think we have to have the opportunity to talk to one of the guys what happened up there. So, Ådne Christensen and Kamil Dostal, it was a hard battle up there. We don't have the jury decision yet, but let's talk to the racers what happened up there. Ådne.
It was a quite close race to the jump, and I saw he got quite late in the gates and he fell. So I got all the snow in my face and didn't see anything, so I kind of jumped over him. So we'll see what the jury do, but yeah.
So as we hear, it is super, super tight fighting up here, and it's super interesting, I think, also for us and also for the racers. We will see what the jury will say. Thank you, Ådne.
Okay, we just heard that jury decided, and there's a point for Norway. Next heat, it is Trym Nygaard-Løken in the red course and Andre Hegar in the blue. Trym is in the lead, skiing very well here.
Yeah, Trim's really come to power in the last few years, looking really, really strong. I think Andre Hegar is going to have his work cut out today. He's going to take the Norwegian. Trym looking very, very relaxed coming into this skate here. Andre is still pushing hard. It really is man for man on this race today. And there we have it. Trimlocken crossing the line. No point for Norway there.
So Team Norway with Guro Hjelset, Ådne Christensen and Trym Nygaard-Løken are in the next round with 3 points.
Next up, though, we have the next pairing, the Italian and the French pairing. So we'll see Argeline Tambuque take on Lina Attaretti from Italy, followed by Eduardo Alio taking on Matti Lopez from France, and Phil Lau and Julian Giocomelli from Italy. But first up in the gate, we can see Argeline Tambuque on the red course and Lina Attaretti on the blue course. Both looking fairly even at the start gate. Toby, what do you reckon?
Yeah, skiing good. So now Argeline is in the lead. Some problems for Lena, the Italian skier. Okay, skiing really, really strong today. Argeline, she got fourth yesterday. And few podiums in the last races, so she's in really good shape. And I think there is no chance for Lena.
Yeah, Argeline's got a lot of experience racing here on the World Cup circuit. I've done a lot of skiing with her myself in San Juan, France. She trains very, very hard with the team. And there we have it, a win for the French team. So 1-0 to France so far. Both skiers look delighted with that run. You've got to remember, this is a fun event, isn't it, Toby?
Yeah, for sure it is. And also, Lena lost his heat now, but she still has the hope that the men will win their races. So there's nothing lost. 1-0 for France, but there are two more guys coming. So now on the start, Matti Lopez against Eduardo in the red course. Started already.
There we have it. Both races now on course. It looks like... I think we have Matti Lopez leading. Oh, big crash there from Eduardo Alio. Matti Lopez taking quick glance behind, seeing his winning. Let's just hope Eduardo's okay. He's suddenly lost the pole.
But he is moving by himself, so I think nothing bad happened to him, but it looks really spectacular.
We have some big crashes in Telemark. You've got to remember, these guys really are pushing the limit the whole time, not holding back. But here we see Matti Lopez from Mirabel, France, pushing his way into the finish. That'll make it 2-0 to France, and they'll go through into the next round.
Yes, and today it looks like super difficult for the skiers. It seemed to be super, super fast before the jump, and also after they have to move so quickly. We have seen Matti with a little bit of tactic before the jump. He was braking a little bit to get not so much speed and getting the turns after better. So those are really top skiers and they have to brake, so it's really, really difficult to ski for them.
Yeah, absolutely. We still have one last pair of a French-Italian. We have Philippe Lau from France in the red course and Julian Giacomelli in the blue course for Italy.
Yeah, getting super interesting. Both are really good.
Oh, we just see a few mistakes there from Giacomelli from Italy, and Philippe Lau now takes the lead for France. Having said that, Julian's still pushing it hard, taking a slightly lower line in the 360 there. Obviously hasn't paid off.
Yeah, and Julian is a very, very aggressive skier, and it's always a little bit of surprise of him, because when he skis through without any mistake, then he's super, super fast. But a lot of times he has this kind of mistakes, and now he did that, and France is in the finish with 3 points, and unfortunately Italy is out of the game.
Yeah, I have to say that too, it was an interesting run. It looked like Julian had the lead over Phil Lau at the start almost. So it's really, really encouraging to see the Italians on the circuit coming through. So that concludes the first round of the team parallel. We'll be getting underway a little bit later. We'll have the next round. We'll see those that have gone through into the next round. Guys, from Italy, unfortunately knocked out, but did you have a good race?
Yeah, it was fun.
I was going to say that was a great fight against Phil Lau as well in the last round. We saw a few tumbles this morning. It'll be interesting to see exactly who do you think is going to win.
Yeah, the Swiss team, the first team of the Switzerland.
Yeah, Tula Visteko is now with us, legend of this sport, Tobias Müller, who is here. Ne dirka, izvedeli bomo zakaj. Kai, Tobias, welcome to
absolutely
our show.
And,
Lina, you're not racing today because you don't
Angeline
have any girls
I'm
in
so
your team, if I'm correct.
Yeah, yeah, correct. Thank you. First of all,
so
we have
faster,
no girl here.
And maybe next time I can joke my cards.
I invite all the
good, it's always great
to
see both of you at the finish smiling. It's such a fun
race.
Yesterday,
you
to race alongside some of your favorite competitors.
Otherwise, could you tell us something about Carvalho? It's about this race, first time here.
Yeah, we are the first time here, and I think it's representing for all the athletes. It's super nice here. When we see the slope and the surroundings here, it's just perfect for a Telemark event, and I think all the athletes are happy, and me as an athlete representing for all of them, I would say thank you for the organization and everybody. It's really great to be here.
We have a nice chance to speak with you about your success. I mean, your success is amazing. What's your secret? 33 victories in World Cup, if I'm correct, and all the success in World Cups and so on.
I don't know. I think in Telemark it's important to do all the elements pretty good. It's not just skiing or not just skating or not just jumping. You have to put it all together, and I think in the past I was lucky to put this together a lot of times. So yeah, there's not a secret. I don't know.
What's your opinion? Will Telemark become an Olympic sport in the near future? Is there a chance for this?
We as an athlete don't know exactly. That's not our work to do. That's from all the organizers and stuff. But we as athletes, we can ski as good as we can and show the people that is a great. everybody sees Telemark. They say it's amazing, and I think the sport it showed yesterday or today, it is great. So please spread it out and yeah, keep watching.
Final question, your recipe for tomorrow?
Skiing fast.
Great, good luck.
Thank you very much.
Mislim, da imamo še minutko, pa bom poklical še enega gospoda k nam. Here is the representative of our traditional skiing, torej gospod Vidic. Lep dober dan, pozdravljeni v našem prenosu. Kar na klasiki, morda nekaj besed o vašem društvu Gora, pa opremi na kratko, če predstavite vse skupaj.
Ja, lep pozdrav izpred meje. Društvo Gora Predmeja je leta 1895 dobilo prve smučke iz Norveške, to je norveška smučka. Učitelj je čital v časopisu, da se da to nabaviti na norveškem, jih je naročil in potem je začel smučati. In ko je začel smučati, so se spuščal po bregu, so se domačini čudili, kaj je to in so govorili, da gospoda učitelj na sam hudič nese po snegu. Tako je bilo. In to so bile prvo so bile snežke, niti smučke niso bile, so se klicali snežke. No, leta 1995, ob stoletnici te prve tekme, smo dobili podatke, da bo ta tekma na Predmeji. V spustu in teku smo društvo ustanovili in pripravili to tekmovanje in potem vsako leto imamo te tekmovanja. Letos imamo 20. tekmovanje, prav zdaj 8. februarja. Vabim na Predmejo, da čim večje število prijete na ta tekmovanja, smučenje po starom. To je en tak pokal slovenski, ki se dobimo na 11 mestih po Sloveniji. Letos celo v Ptuj bomo šli, so prvič se zdaj zbrala skupina. Tako da je to, promoviramo to staro smučenje, mi pa še posebej to Telemark tehniko, katero nas je naučil Miran Stanovnik, puščavski lisjak. On nas je prve korake Telemarka naučil, no tako da smo mi s tem Telemarkom šli v svet. Smo bili v Livinju leta 96 in smo tudi zmagali, celo Norvežane smo premagali takrat.
No, da vas vprašam kot nekdani alpski smučar, če poveste gledalcem takole laično, kako izgleda, kakšne so razlike med alpskim smučanjem in Telemarkom?
We saw, again, a few crashes as well, which was makes it a bit more exciting. Thankfully, everyone's still intact. Toby, what's your prediction? Do you think you might win this today?
Yeah, it's difficult to say actually, but Swiss guys with Amelie, Nico and Stefan, they look very, very good on the paper, but in a parallel and especially in a team parallel, everything can happen. So I would guess that we will have Switzerland and France into the big final, but as said, everything can happen.
Yeah, absolutely. It'd be nice to see the Slovenians go through. Being in Slovenia here, they've got plenty of support from all the locals. But you're right, the Swiss are exceptionally strong. Amelie Raymond won yesterday, and the same with Stefan Matter. It really was a double win for the Swiss team. Having said that, the French are also skiing well. Angeline had a good race yesterday. And Philippe Lau and Mati Lopez, also very, very quick indeed. So it really is anyone's game here today. Just a quick recap in case you missed out yesterday. We are doing the parallel sprint today. So it consists of an element of giant slalom racing, a bit of jumping, cross-country skating. It's a very, very diverse sport.
It is, and I think that makes it so interesting for the racers and also for the guys watching it.
Yeah, it's requires in training, it requires a certain different types of training. Obviously, a bit of cardiovascular sort of for the skates, also some jump practice, and obviously lots of giant slalom training. But Toby, tell us a bit about your summer preparation, how you prepare for this race.
Yeah, that's the difficult thing in summer because, as you said, we have to prepare for all the different, I would say, disciplines. So I'm a lot on roller skis for the cross-country training. We are a lot of times ski jumping in Oberstdorf at the ski jumping hills. And, of course, a lot of training in the gym. And so, yeah, it's hard to find the right way with all the trainings connected, but I think everybody has over the years got a little bit of experience and knows what is good for him the best, and it's good to give these experiences further to the younger guys, And in our team we are training together a lot because most of the skiers are based in our Allgäu near Oberjoch, where we have the World Cup next year. So it's easy for us to train together.
Next up though, we're now about to start the next race. We see Katarina Malinsek from Slovenia in the red course, Amelie Raymond, Switzerland in the blue course, now on course. Amelie taking the lead for Switzerland.
Yeah, she is skiing really strong today as well. Always, that's not a surprise that she is super good. But what's nice with her, she's doing it clever all the time. She's not risking all, she's doing it really clever over the jump and so much experience. It's really amazing to see how she skis.
Yeah, Amelie with 182 podiums to her name. She really is the ice queen over here. She's overtaken Lindsay Vonn in a number of World Cup podiums. And it looks like a win for Switzerland there over Katarina Malinsek from Slovenia. But next up, we have two more Swiss and Slovenian racers. We have Nicolas Michel from Switzerland and Rock Schmidt from Slovenia. We can see in the replay here, Amelie is just so stable over skis, really is absolutely bulletproof coming under. But next up, we can see the Slovenian in the blue course and Nicolas Michel from Switzerland in the red course.
Let's see what the guys are doing. They are a little bit more speed all the way down and it's going to be interesting. They started now, Nicolas with a good start in the red course. Nice skiing. Nico in the lead. Rock skiing pretty strong too. Oh, nice, nice, nice.
Yeah, really, really strong. Fast jump. I was speaking to Troels Larsen, who set the course earlier, the Norwegian. And he was saying it's a very, very quick course coming, certainly off a jump. Skis will take a lot of speed. But now into the skate. Rock is not giving up. He's chasing Nicolas Michel. A bit of a slip on the exit.
That means 2 points for Switzerland, so they are safe in the final. But let's see what Stefan and Sajo are showing in the last round.
There we have it. Stefan Mata in the blue course and Sasha Elish from Slovenia in the red course. Now getting ready to go, waiting for the starters' orders, and they'll be off.
Stefan in blue. And Sajo in red started now. Oh yeah, Stefan, he's strong from really the top to the bottom here. Skiing really good, no tactic, just full speed on, and he's in the lead.
Yeah, Stefan, like Amelie, she's so solid over the skis. Very, very big, secure base. Taking a bit of a lead out there over Sasha Elish. Plenty of support, though, in Slovenia for the Slovenian team. And there we have it. It looks like Stefan's going to take it again for Switzerland. So 3 wins to Switzerland, 0 to Slovenia. What was a very exciting race.
Congratulations to Switzerland for victory. And see the guys again. Really nice skiing. Both of them. And yeah, the Swiss guys are really comfortable in the lead with 3 points going to the final. And I would say this team is top favorite for the win today.
Next up though, we have Guro Heldesep from Norway in the blue course and Aigeline Tambouke from France in the red course. What again I think will be a very, very exciting race. I'd say probably out of most of the skiers here racing today, these are probably the best matched pair we've seen.
Of course, I think that is the quarterfinal of the ladies' race from yesterday. And Aigeline came through and they started.
Yeah, yesterday we saw a little bit of a slightly controversial race. We saw Aigeline just put her elbow out a little bit, but it happened. Guro actually missed a gate. Now on course, though, it looks like they're making easy work of it. So a little bit of a slip and slide.
Some problems for Aigeline there. Guro in the lead by one gate. And now in the skating part, it's going to be interesting with the penalties because Arjali May is the faster skater, but I think that is the first point for Norway.
Yes, it's a tough one here. I really thought Arjali had it, but there we have it. First point for Norway, and Guro Heldesep looks absolutely delighted.
And that's really nice for the girls because it was exactly the revenge from yesterday. Arjaline won yesterday and Guro today. So that's nice to see girls skiing on the same level and just the payback of Guro today.
Yeah, it just goes to set, just goes to show, you know, from one day to the next, we really do get very, very mixed results, especially in these team parallels. But next up, though, we have Matti Lopez from France in the blue course and Adne Kristoffersen from Norway in the red course.
And he was complaining that you say his name always wrong.
I do, Christiansen.
But now they are on the course. It's going to be super interesting. All same. Nice feeling of both. Super similar. And yes, nice fight from the two good friends.
Yeah, wow, really, really level coming into the wrap. It looked like Matti Lopez maybe just holding off slightly, almost letting Nicola go ahead.
More penalty for Adne, so it's so interesting. It's a nice fight until the end, and it will be.
Wow, look at that. That really was right down to the mark. It'd be interesting to find out who won that one.
That was Adne, and the second point for Norway, but I think that was the best fight of the whole day today. So close, so much fighting in the course, in the loop, and in the skating. That's what our sport makes so interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. That really was from top to bottom a fight the whole way down. But last of all, we've got the final pair from Norway, France. Grim Løkken from Norway coming up against Chris Lau. So we see Chris Lau in the red course here to the right of your screen. Sorry, Phil Lau even.
Yeah, but the three brothers were former skiers. They were pretty good. Phil is still competing and on the red course now. And they're going to start soon. Go for it, guys!
There we have it, both races straight out the course. It looks like the Norwegian has a slight lead over Phil Lau, which is an interesting race.
Yeah, it's really interesting now, but Phil is so confident and is taking the lead now. The skiing of him is really impressive, so clean and so smooth.
Having said that, I know Trim's had a great summer training, especially he's very, very strong in this skate, so I wouldn't necessarily call it this early on. It's looking very close. Trim Løkken coming through. Wow, what a finish from both racers. We're going to have to find out exactly who won that one. That really was down to the line, but I think the red court, blue course, may have just won that. We'll wait for the jury decision.
We could see that Phil was a little bit saving energy for the race tomorrow because Norway had 2 points before, so it was no chance for Phil to win this race. So I think he just saved some energy for tomorrow and didn't skate full on. But that means 3 points for Norway and final.
Wow, that really was an exciting lineup. So we'll see the Norwegians come up against the Swiss in what will be a very, very exciting final of this Telemark team parallel. Toby, tell me a little bit about tomorrow. We have the sprint, which is obviously very different to the race we got today and the race we had yesterday, the parallel. It's just timed. Tell me what are your thoughts going into it.
Yeah, it's for sure it's different. Skiing man against man is totally different for your head and for your mind. So you're a little bit more nervous and everything can happen and it's like a little bit of different nervosity on the start. And tomorrow we have the sprint. We are skiing alone, just against the clock and on a different slope. We will see how it goes, but it's a totally different race and the cards are totally new for tomorrow's race.
Another big difference, there'll be two different courses. So the skiers will ski one course first off, and then another coach will set the second course. So that sometimes plays in the favour of certain athletes. Obviously, Norwegians set the course today. They've come through to the final against the Swiss. It'll be interesting to see whether it will pay off whether that Norwegian course will pay dividends for the Norwegians. We're going to wrap up there, but we'll be back with you in the final in about 10-15 minutes time. Thank you.
Spice, torej, oglašamo tule iz cilja, tekmovalci so na poti nazaj, gor na štart, tiste, ki seveda čaka še nastop. Z nami pa je Jure Sodja, gospod, ki je zelo povezan s Telemarkom, pomagal velikokrat pri organizaciji tekem in mislim, da nam lahko pove tudi kakšno zanimivost iz zakulisja o tem, kakšni so tekmovalci, pravzaprav vse zelo dobro pozna.
Ja, tako je, glede na to, da smo v Bohinju tok let organizirali dirko, sem res tudi z njimi postal velik osebni prijatelj, z nekaterimi smo se videli tudi izven Telemarka, ne samo po zimi na snegu, ampak tudi po leti so prišli s družinami. Tako da trenutno je stanje tako, da so določene punce so noseče v tem športu, zato tudi kakšnih ni, marsikdo študira. Žal je res ta datum zoprn, ker ima predvsem Nemci ima zdaj le na faksih največ izpitev. In zato nekateri so se celo meni osebno pač preko socialnih medijev upravičili, da žal nas pa letos ne bo, ker in bi tako radi prišli, ampak žal.
In šport res zelo povezuje, recimo ugotavljala sva že glede Bohinja in tudi sicer v Slovenijo se radi vračajo, pravijo vsi kosti, da je čudovita destinacija, tudi Krvavec pravzaprav hvalijo na vsakem koraku.
Ja, absolutno, Slovenija je kar nekako zapisana v tem športu, jaz mislim zelo dobro, slovimo kot srčni organizatori, slovimo kot organizatori, ki smo trmasti, ker včasih tudi, ko nimamo ne snega, ne še malo česa drugega, da ne govorimo glih ravno o denarju, a ne? Imamo pa marsikaj drugega in to spoštujejo, to cenijo, pridejo, prihajajo v Slovenijo. Če bi vprašala zdaj Tobija, ne, verjetno si ga že vprašal v intervjuju, sem všeč tudi verjetno slovenske punce, tako da sama dobra slava gre tudi skozi Telemark po svetu.
Ok, če imamo še nekaj časa, pa bom kar stopil do Tobiasa. Tobias, I'm gonna catch you in between SMSing. We have a chance. Really, really close today also. You were watching the whole time.
Yeah, sure. It's also for us interesting. It's a little bit different to be on the other side of the race. And yeah, it's my fingers are quivering and I really want to race, but it's also really nice to watch it from the other side. And now I know why all the spectators are so interested in the sport, because really the fights are so close and it's so nice and yeah, it's intense to watch.
If I ask you about this role, I mean, you're commentating for the British television and you're excellent.
Thank you very much. It's the first time I try my best, but I think I should go on skiing and not commentating, because I think I'm way better in skiing.
So we're gonna wish all the best for tomorrow, as said, and now we're going back to our studio. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Torej, toliko iz Izteka. Slišimo se spet po koncu tekme, ko bodo z nami tudi najboljši.
Lepa. Hvala. Malo zdaj manjci.
Super.
Thank you.
Zdaj 4-6 ton.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to CombatFit. Here we are in Slovenia. We're just waiting for the small final and the main final of the today's parallel sprint. Team parallel sprint even. So we saw a phenomenal first set of races this morning, which has led to the small final, who will be fighting for a bronze medal, which will be fought between the French and the Slovenians. And the actual final today, which will be between the Swiss and the Norwegians. So the Swiss, I have to say, are looking exceptionally strong. They have on their team today, on the A team, they have Stefan Mata, who won the men's race yesterday, alongside Amelie Raymond, who is absolutely unbeatable this season. She hasn't lost a race yet. So it'll be interesting to see exactly how they get on. That's to say, not to discredit the Norwegians, they also have an exceptionally strong team, with the likes of Trym Løkken, Arne Kristoffersen, and also Guro Helda Skjelset from Norway. So this will be a pretty spectacular showdown for the final. Joining me in a few minutes, we'll also have Toby Müller from the German team. So unfortunately, the Germans won't be racing today in the team parallel. Reason being, you need to have one man, one lady racing. Unfortunately, it's just no ladies out here. I understand, unfortunately, Joanna Holtzman is injured, and some of the younger girls are actually studying for exams, which will be happening any day now. So very best of luck to Joanna on her swift recovery, and to everyone else studying for exams out there. I understand their frustration. I was in their shoes once upon a time. But we'll just be waiting for the final now. I expect a 2 or 3 minute wait while the guys get up there, start getting kitted up. But join me again, Toby Müller from Germany. Toby, talk to me a little bit about the final season. The exciting lineup. We've got the Swiss and Norwegians, two very powerful nations.
Yeah, for sure, it will be super, super interesting, but it's the final. And in the semi-finals, both of the teams are in the final. They skied
really comfortable to the final with 3 points, both of them. So it's going to be super interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. Like you say, both teams won straight out last time, 3 points and 3 points. So the way it works is the teams have 3 skiers per team, and they will get 1 point when they come up against the opposition and win. So we're just getting ready now. I heard from our World Cup coordinator, we're getting ready for the small final. So we'll see the French take on the Slovenians. And in the first round, we'll see Argeline Tambouke from France taking on Katarina Malencek from Slovenia. Yeah, this will be an interesting race. I have to say, Argeline is skiing exceptionally well today. Unfortunately, she didn't beat the Norwegian last time, hence they've gone through to the final. She had a good fight against Guru Helsep, but this time she'll come up against the young Celine and the youngest girl actually on the circuit today, Katarina Malencek.
Yeah, Czech, you are commentating very well, but with the Norwegian names we have to learn a little bit.
We certainly do, and apologies for any mispronunciations. I'm working on the pronunciations, which come on a bit. I have to say, Guru has commended me. I understand it is... got it now, Toby. Guru Helensek. Helensek.
Guru Helensek.
That's the one. Good job I've got Toby in the commentary box here with me. But here we see the first lineup: Argeline Tambouke in the red course and Katarina Malencek from Slovenia in the blue course.
Now we see Argeline focused in the red course. Getting ready now. And it is blue course ready, red course ready, attention, and then they start.
Yeah, it's important to mention the starting commands are the same across the whole World Cup. So these races will now be familiar with exactly what's going on. We can see Guru Heldesept. Is that Guru? No, is that Adne? Adne, sorry, to the left of the screen, on overlooking the small final, getting psyched up. They'll be off any second now.
Yeah, that's interesting because all the other racers are just watching the girls and hoping for a win. Now they started the small final. Argeline in the lead, coming to the jump now.
Yeah, Argeline certainly over the jump first, taking probably a 2-gate lead now over Katarina Malencek from Slovenia.
And she will go in the loop as first, but also for the Slovenian girl, I think it's a nice opportunity and a nice race training for her today, and doing a lot of jumps, a lot of 360s, and a great opportunity to race here.
Absolutely, I think it's great for Slovenians getting a race on a home hill here. But here we have it, Argeline Tambouke from France crossing the line, making it 1 point to the French team. So just a reminder, it will be the best of the fastest 2 times, sorry, which will count. So we'll see 2 other races from the French and Slovenians. We'll see Rok Schmidt from Slovenia and Matty Lopez, followed by Phil Lau and Sasha Elish.
It's actually not the fastest time, it's going with the points. The team with 2 points out of the 3 races is the winner.
Thank you, Toby. Good correction right there. I'm glad to have you here with me commentating. But next up, we see Matty Lopez and Rok Schmidt now on course.
Matty in the blue course with the tactic jump again and in the lead, but it's super close and still close into the loom. Okay, Matty a little bit in lead, but now nothing lost, a little mistake of Rok in the loom, and it will be the victory for Matty Lopez.
Yes, we saw Rok just getting very, very high into the 360 there. Just maybe losing a little bit of speed, and it's another win for France. So 2 wins for France. That will secure them the bronze medal. What a brilliant race.
Yeah, congrats to France for the bronze medal, but we will concentrate for Phil and Sajo for the last battle. There we see the mistake of Rock in the 360.
Yeah, it's very easily done. It's a very, very big 360. And certainly if you get your line right, you lose a lot of speed coming out, heading up to the next yellow control gate. But
and Sajo started Phil in the red course. Oh, problems for the Slovenian guy. Phil skiing super confident and a little bit late now. But he will go as the first in the 360. But the Slovenian is coming with more speed. It's going to be interesting.
Yeah, Saša Eliš is fighting back for Slovenia now. Having said that, Phil's looking very, very comfortable into the skate. I think he maybe just taking it a little bit easier now. He's got the win in his sights. And there we have it. Phil Lau taking the win. 3-0 to France.
Yes. So France with 3 points. Congrats to them. But it was still a really nice match between the guys and really cool to watch.
Yeah, what a brilliant small final. And I'm sure the French will be delighted to come away with one bronze medal from here in Slovenia. Certainly, still got another race tomorrow. But first of all, we've got the final of this team parallel. And we'll see in the first round, the Switzerland's unbeatable Amelie Raymond come up against Guro Helda Selset from Norway, followed by Arne Christiansen from Norway and Nicolas Michel from Switzerland. And then bring up the rear, we'll see Stefan Michel and Tim Lokan from Norway. But first of all, Amelie Raymond in the blue course of Switzerland and Guro Helda Selset for Norway in the red course.
Let's get ready for the finals. And when we watch, and they started, final is on. Amelie blue in the lead, Guro skiing well. And that's close, nice to see the girl skiing. Oh, little mistake of Amelie, and Guro is in the lead.
Toby, this is a really exciting race. I don't think I've ever seen anyone come quite so close to Amelie in a parallel. Guro taking the shorter line. I don't think she's taking as much speed out of it. Amelie's skating hard now.
Wow, what a nice match till the 360. And that will be point for Amelie. But I think she's going to be surprised that Guro was so close in the gates. Really, really big applause for both of the girls and Guro. Well done to force Amelie that hard.
Yeah, I was super impressed there. I don't think I've ever seen Guro ski so well. Coming up against Amelie, they really were head-to-head all the way down through the gates. A little bit of a slip-up from Amelie in the lower half. Almost made Guro tee it back. We see Guro in the 360 here, cut it a little bit short. Interesting tactic. I don't think in this 360 it necessarily works, though.
Wow, that was an intense final. But now getting ready for the guys. Nicola in blue and Otne. No, sorry. Nico in red and Otne in blue. Let's see what the guys are doing down here. That's going to be super interesting.
Again, another really, really well-matched pair. This will be, I suspect, will be a very, very close race to the finish.
Wow, good skis. Both on the top. Nico a little bit in the lead in the red course. All problems after jump of Omne. That will be penalties. Woo! Okay, Nico entered the 360 first. We will see what the penalty will say. Oh,
there we have it. The Norwegian Trim Lokan coming up from the bottom. Interesting tactic, same as his teammate Guro there, but it's obviously paid off for Nicolas Michel, who's now taking the lead over Norwegian.
Wow, another super close final. But there is the second point for Switzerland. So we know now that Switzerland will be the winner. But congrats to Switzerland.
Yeah, I have to say, this is, really is one of the closest team parallels I've seen in a long time. But we do still have the final lineup: Stefan Matte from Switzerland and Tim Løkken from Norway. Again, another very well matched pair. Stefan Matte on the blue course, Tim Løkken from Norway in the red course. Let's just see how they get on the final round. Always slightly difficult when you're at the top of the course, you know who's won, but here we see them now underway.
Oh yeah, strong skiing. Problem of Trim. Stefan skiing super safe down, and Trim is out.
Yeah, I have to say, Trim was looking fairly wild coming off that jump. Looks like a cowboy, one leg up in the air. But there we have it. Stefan Matte, the winner from yesterday, cruising through the skate now. And it is a win for Switzerland. What a fantastic race.
So that's pretty, pretty strong. And maybe we have this team also as a top favorite.
Guys, many congratulations to the Swiss team. How did you get on today?
Yeah, it was really cool. It's good to race in team again, and it was a nice event.
Nicola, really, really close, well-matched race. How did you find it?
It was a really nice day. All the racers were really strong, and at the end we are happy to be the winner of today.
Awesome. Well, many, many congratulations. Toby, any final thoughts?
It was just an intense final. It was so nice to ski, and everybody was fighting so hard, and you could see that all the races were pushing the limits pretty much, and maybe the biggest surprise of the today's final was Guru skiing so strong. She was really coming out of herself, and big respect for that.
Brilliant. Well, thank you very much again for watching today. We're going to wrap it up there, but we'll be back tomorrow same time for the sprint. That's all for now. Toby Müller and Jack Harvard-Taylor out.
That's the key for to win a team race. What is easier, to start the team race or to be the last one? Because it's probably very hard if you're the last, if the result is like you have to decide it.
Yeah, if you have two before you, good races like Amelie and Nico, then it's no problem to be the number three, because they win two runs and then I can win also.
Tomorrow another race, your recipe for tomorrow?
Yes, I'm ready, and I hope for a good race.
Okay, good luck for tomorrow. Thank you. Toliko Tore iz Izteka, spet predajam besedo studio.
Thank you.
Okay, spet se selimo tule v Iztek, z nami pa odgovorna oseba Andreja, ki je vodila vse, da je vse skupaj potekalo brezhibno, nekaj vtisov o teh prvih dveh tekmah iz Krvavca.
Ja, mislim, da prizorišče tule gor na Krvavcu res fantastično. V bistvu je zmišljen za nas tele proge in vse skupaj. In vzdušje je super. Med finiš to dole noter na plaži, se mi zdi, da boljšega skor ne more biti. Organizatori, ne morem jih prehvaliti, ker res, če gor se pogledate, se vidi, da proga je narejena v nulo. In mislim, da čisto vsi smo do konca zadovoljni. Tekmovalci in sploh vsi. No.
Če vas vprašamo o vaših izzivih v vlogi vodje tekmovanja, ta vloga je zelo odgovorna, veliko stvari je treba upoštevati, paziti na veliko stvari. Če nam zaupate nekaj podrobnosti v zvezi s tem.
Ja, moje delo tu je, jaz sem res direktor poslane s FIS, ne, jaz moram pač poskrbeti, da tekme potekajo nemoteno po FIS pravilih.
Ste imeli kakšne težave? Ja.
Ne, do zdaj še nič.
Na koncu še napoved za jutri, kaj lahko poveste našim gledalcem, jih morda povabite, da se ogledajo tudi jutri še en spektakel nas čaka.
Ja, absolutno, absolutno. Jaz sem pripričal, da bomo jutri imeli še eno, ni tako dobro tekmo kot kordon. Sicer drugo disciplino, ampak lahko bolj za pogledati.
Hvala lepa. Tako torej, toliko z Izteka, spet se selimo v studio. Ja, tule se zelo veliko dogaja, ampak imamo srečo, kajti z nami je pravzaprav zdajle prvi človek Telemarka v Sloveniji in na začetku bom poprašal, tekma je končana, vaši vtisi, novo prizorišče, vsi tekmovalci so zelo zadovoljni. Zadovoljni, kaj pa bi vi povedali pravzaprav o tem spektaklu tule na Krvavcu?
Najprej lep pozdrav vsem skupaj. Ja, moram reči, da je Krvavc prava izbira bila letos za Telemark svetovno pokal in sem pripričan, da naslednje leto bomo tudi tukaj in vse pohvale in organizaciji, tekmovalcem in upam, da naslednje leto bo še več.
Ste najboljši naslov, da vas poprašam tudi o zakulisju tega športa v Sloveniji. Nekaj besed o tem, kje je slovenski Telemark, kam gre?
Ja, slovenski Telemark oziroma Telemark v Sloveniji se razvija še vedno. Pač finančne omejitve ne zadržujemo bližje, ampak mislim, da bomo tudi to rešili z dobrim delom.
Kakšen pa je nasploh položaj Telemarka v tej družini smučanja? Veliko načrtov se sliši oziroma govori se o tem, da je seveda želja, da bi nekoč to postal olimpijski šport. Morda kakšna beseda z tega področja, kakšna informacija, kakšna zanimivosti za kulisja, kam gredo ti napori?
Ja, želje so res velike, da bi Telemark olimpijski šport. S tem bi tudi pridobili pri sponzorih, verjetno lažje pogodbe, več denarja, pač to je cirkus nekaj. In žalostni smo bili že sedaj, ker nas niso sprejeli, pa upamo na eno prihodnost bližnjo del.
Prav na koncu še vprašanje povezano z najmlajšimi. Seveda veliko staršev tudi gleda tale prenos. Kakšen svet, zakaj pripeljati otroke v Telemark in kje pravzaprav je priložnost za najmlajše, da preizkusijo ta šport?
Ja, mladi z problemi v tem, ki niso se znani s tem športom. Ampak mislim, da bomo prišli tudi na klubsko raven pri mlajših, da jih nekako motiviramo, da bo prvo to prosto peto in uživamo ne samo po progah, tudi izven prog.
Ok, hvala lepa. No, to je bilo pa res danes zadnjič tule oglašanje iz Izteka. Tudi v najnem imenu pa seveda vabim vse, ki ste bili danes morda pred zasloni, da jutri pridete na Krvavec in si vse skupaj ogledate tudi uživo. We'll be right back.